Okay. This is the beginning of the Leona tutorial video. I know this is one that a handful of people have really wanted to see, so I wanted to push this one up in the schedule here. Leona is, in my opinion, one of the most misunderstood characters in KOF13. At the very beginning, a handful of good players, who are my personal friends, The Answer, Bala, and Romance, they made a preliminary tier list, and they put Leona at the very bottom spot. Since then, she's had this sort of bottom tier, this sort of bottom tier air about her that seems to have fallen her around on the forums and other things. I don't necessarily think she is a top tier character, but I absolutely would say she is nowhere near the absolute bottom. She has to at least be mid-low for what Leona has, and I'm going to show you what Leona has in this video. Leona is a multifaceted character that can be played in multiple ways, okay? This super in particular grants her an effective range for one bar that is even better than that of Terry. Excuse me. It's better than that of almost any character in the game. Leona can make you scared of jumping from 80% of the screen away. This super move, combined with the fact that she can run up and poke you and have a frame advantage of zero, and the fact that she also has a full screen way of guaranteeing pressure, almost like a Marvel assist, these things together make her suited to the defensive game. Her close range normals aren't the greatest. In fact, her close C and her close D are both slower than her crouching normals, and that's a little odd. However, well, it's odd compared to other KOF characters, but Leona has a very competent offense and one of the scariest in the game, because if you can get block stun and if you can get your opponent to crouch guard... Oh, wow, I can't even do it. If you can get your opponent to crouch guard, Leona can instantly take 200 or more damage off of your life by making you choose between a low or a high guard. It's impossible for you to see this. I will cover the instant overhead in more detail later in the video, but I just wanted to let you know that her instant overhead, her air super, her long range options, and the fact that she has really, really good air-to-air normals and preemptive anti-airs as well, make her a slightly more defensive than offensive character, but her offense is no slouch, because in your face she will make you guess 50-50, and I mean, it's not technically a 50-50 due to the defensive options. There's things like backdashes and rolling, but if you choose to block, if you are going to pick a high or a low guard, then she can 50-50 you, take gigantic chunks off of your life, and also, one last thing, her hyperdrive mode damage rivals that of Shen. Shen is considered one of the highest damage characters in the game on hyperdrive. Leona, for the exact same amount of meter in every screen position, does about the same damage, with a difference of usually 50 to 60 damage, not even up to 80. Her HD combos always do 80 or closer damage for the same amount of bar in the same screen positions as Shen, and people play Shen for his damage. That means that Leona, you should also be playing for her damage. She can kill you for 4 bars on HD from full screen, just like Shen can. Now, that was the overview, so let's get into the nitty-gritty. Leona's standing normals, let's start with those. They're really nothing to write home about. Her standing A is fairly standard, you know, quick standing normal. Her standing light kick, it is a low attack, so they do have to guard this low. It's one of the good standing lows. It's also chainable into her command normal, and I'll get into that a little more. Her standing C moves her forward. It's really good pressure. There's a lot of characters for which... Crouch all guard. Come on. There's a lot of characters for which, after a ground string, you can use far C to move forward and kind of frame trap them and keep them in place. Her standing C is a really good way to continue the pressure. Okay. Her standing D, her standing hard kick, has a good anti-air angle on it. It's a little slow on startup, so you're not really going to be reacting to any full jumps with this, but it is a decent preemptive anti-air for that purpose. It also works on pretty much everyone in the game crouching, as far as I'm aware. So this will not miss on anyone if you stick that after a string, okay? So similar to standing C, you can use it after a string to push them away safely. Her standing CD is one that you really should take note of, though. It doesn't really have a good wind back, but it goes forward a lot. It looks very similar to Vice's, and that she sticks her hand out. However, this this CD, in fact, let me just go ahead and show you the guard on this. Even if you are point blank, you're only about minus one frame advantage. I'm pretty sure that is minus one. But it has a lot of active frames, which means if you use it near the tip of it, at the end of it, of the range, you can actually make it even, or you can even give it frame advantage. Now, frame advantage at that range won't be terribly useful, but in Leona's case, well, what should I say, it wouldn't be terribly useful to most characters, but in Leona's case, this frame advantage means that if I were to neutral jump and see them jump, I get that super. Her standing CD is an excellent pressure tool, because when you use it at the tip range, you can lock down their movement options using this frame advantage. And because it is cancelable, you can also go into her special moves and try to catch them if they flinch. Okay, so those are her standing normals. Jumping normals. In fact, let's go crouching first. She has a very good crouching light kick. Her crouching light kick gives her plus two on block. Most characters have plus one or zero. In her case, her crouching light kick is plus two on block. It's really, really excellent for pressure. Her crouching A is also plus on block. Her crouching C is very fast. In fact, it's her fastest close range normal. It starts up really fast. And if you land a crouching B, you can actually link a crouching C. Let me go ahead and show you that one. It's possible to link these two together on hit. There we go, two-hit combo. So you can use that. You can also use it as a frame trap for many of your crouching normals. And it is chainable as well. So you could go into your command normal followed by combos. Okay, her crouching hard kick. It reaches decently far, not the best, but it does hit a little bit off the ground. It gives it a tiny, tiny bit of utility as like a hop anti-air, not really. But it does hit low, and it does reach from three pokes away, so you can use it for all the fundamental frame traps that you've seen in that 20-minute tutorial video and elsewise. It is pretty slow on startup compared to some others, though. I wouldn't overuse it, but it is functional when you compare it to other characters' crouching deeps. Jumping normal-wise, she's got four of them. Let's see. Her jumping light punch is very fast on startup, and I will come back to jumping light punch later when I get to the instant overhead section. However, by itself in the neutral game, it doesn't serve a lot of purpose. It's not active for very long. As you can see, she's already wound her punch back. I honestly don't use this poke a whole lot in the neutral game. Her jumping light kick, though, has a really good horizontal angle. It is almost perfectly horizontal, making it well-suited for air-to-air situations. Okay, her jumping hard kick is similar. This has a similar angle to, say, Clark's jumping CD. It's a little bit down, so it's a good air-to-air and kind of an air-to-ground at the same time because of that low angle that it has. And jumping hard punch has a similar story. Also decent anti-air and decent air-to-ground. Her normals are very, I don't want to say bubblegummy because that's not the right word. Her normals are multi-purpose, okay? Most of her normals you can use in multiple ways. I will caution you from overusing jumping light kick, though, because jumping light kick will whiff on, well, assuming this dummy actually stays crouching here. Her jumping light kick will actually whiff. Okay, her jumping light kick will actually whiff on every crouching character in the game. So don't overuse it, otherwise you will get anti-aired with their crouching B. Let's see. Her jumping C, this is the jump in I use the most. It actually has a cross-up hitbox on it. And it's actually a good cross-up hitbox on it. It's not a bad one at all. The problem is she doesn't have a lot of knockdowns that sets up into it. There's certain knockdowns that if they don't tech, if they don't do a quick recovery, you can use this as a cross-up. But overall, because of her hop height, because of her full jump timing, because of her knockdowns, you won't really have much of an opportunity to actually use this as a cross-up, but it is still one of her more functional jump-in normals. Jumping C and jumping D are very similar. The only real difference is that jumping D seems to reach a little further. Yeah, jumping D reaches a little further, but it doesn't have a cross-up hitbox on it. Yeah, okay. Now, her jumping CD deserves special note, partially because it's a reference to certain Japanese TV shows. I won't go any further in depth than that. Hopefully some of you guys know what I'm talking about. Her jumping CD is, I have to unfortunately say, one of the worst ones in the game. Now, it's still a jumping CD. It still knocks down, and it still has excellent guard stun on block, which allows you to run up and do good mix-ups. However, it's pretty slow on startup compared to some other characters. Also, the angle on it, it is good air-to-air and air-to-ground similar at the same time, but when she has three normals that hit the same angle, its utility goes down. Her jumping CD is pretty... It is functional as a jumping CD, but just like her crouching D, it's really nothing special. The slow startup on it tends to hurt it in a lot of mid-neutral game situations. When you're hopping around in the air with Leona, I would suggest hitting light kick, hard punch, or hard kick most of the time, and only using CD when you really know it's going to hit, or you really know they're going to block it. I wouldn't throw it out like, say, you might do with King, or like you might do with Chin, or like you might do with Clark. It's a little too slow to use for that purpose. Okay, those are her jumping normals, standing normals, and crouching normals. Now let me get into her normal throw here. Leona Crash. It is unfortunately techable, so you're not going to be getting any sort of guaranteed pressure after this throw. It has a long recovery on it. Even if you follow it with your Grand Blade, they do actually recover really, really, really fast, so they will be able to react to everything. One of the worst normal throws in the game, unfortunately, nothing you can follow up with except more neutral game. What you can try to do after that is maybe hyper hop away and then go into maybe an earring game or into a full screen air super game. Again, occupying that space. Strike Arch, this normal right here. This is an overhead. Okay, when this hits, it actually causes an untechable knockdown. Remember, the passive move is on. So if you trip them, and it's possible for them to detect the knockdown, the dummy will. This forward light kick is an overhead, and it causes an untechable knockdown. This gives it a lot of use because if you hop immediately, you can practically guarantee pressure. If you're not familiar with the term, this is actually a safe jump. If you hop immediately after the overhead, this is a safe jump that beats reversals that are 3 frames or slower, which, by the way, is 99% of them in the game, including Kim's EX flash kick. I won't go too far in depth with safe jumps, but if you know what they are, this grants you a safe jump setup, and it's very, very useful if you can ever get it to land. However, like most command normals that are overheads, it does lose its overhead capability if you chain into it. So let's set him to crouch one-hit guard. If you do chain into it, it is no longer an overhead at that point. However, you can still use it for all your basic confirms. Okay, this includes from your close normals. And when you do hit with the move, you are airborne, so you are able to use your air specials and air supers when that actually does connect. Notice that that is her air super, okay? It is also not the greatest on block, actually. Let me go ahead and try and punish this. I'm pretty sure it's punishable by most of the cast. Let's see, let me find a way to do this. No, you know what? Let me move on. Let me just say that as a general tip, if they do block this, you will have frame disadvantage. Let's start with that. Okay. It is a significant amount. We're talking minus 7, minus 8, possibly. I can look up the frame data. I'm putting the frame data link in every single video that I'm posting, so if you're curious about any of the frame data, you can look it up. They're all in the description there. But in the corner, it doesn't cause any pushback, so you're minus 6 or 7 or whatever the number is right in their face, and they will be able to punish you. So you want to not use it as much when they are cornered. Just keep that in mind, unless you, of course, fully confirm into it so that you know that it did hit. Okay, now that's her normals. Let's go into the specials. Baltic Launcher. This move is not as useful as it might look. It looks like a big blue ball of death, but what it comes down to is it serves a couple of main purposes. And let me go backwards here. I'm actually going to start with the hard punch version. The hard punch version, I want you to notice where it comes out. Like, notice the height of it. If we look at the back of the stage here, Notice the little boy who's sitting on his knees, and notice how far it is above his head, right? Now I'm going to do the light punch version. As you can see, this one is much closer to the little boy's head, okay? The light and hard version both have similar startup times, but the hard punch version has a higher angle on it. Also, notice the light punch version stays in place. The fierce punch version moves forward ever so slightly. So what they're for is the light punch version. The light punch version can be used on grounded opponents who are being too defensive. If they actually block this, you have a ridiculous amount of frame advantage, and you can use that however you like. Okay, you can actually guarantee a low or a high attack while they're in block stun. Hint, hint, I'll get to it later. Okay, the high version, they will block if they're standing, however, the high version misses on everyone in the game who is crouching. Okay, so the high version is designed not for ground pressure, but as a preemptive anti-air. I will show you. If you throw this out a hair before they jump, they will land in it. And when they land in it and they eat all those hits, you will get a full juggle state, which means you can follow it up with whatever you want. It's possible for you to do lots of things with this depending on how much meter you have, but the basic idea is if they fall in this, they're going to eat a lot of damage. So you want to use the hard punch version occasionally, occasionally. Notice I hit this button before she jumped. As a preemptive anti-air, because if they hop or full jump into it, and due to the angle on it, it's very difficult not to jump into it if you do jump. If they jump into it and they eat all those hits, you will be able to get a super or something else at least, at the very least a jumping CD for the knockdown, more pressure, okay? You want them to try to jump into it, but you don't want to overuse it. The reason you don't want to overuse it is because it is possible for characters to just crouching hard kick right under it. Most characters can do a crouching hard kick that reaches far enough to go through it. It's also very slow on startup, and it's also very obvious that it's out. It has like almost a full second, if not more, of recovery time. There's a lot of characters that could just see that and super right through it, like Iori, like Kyo. Like, as long as if they're close enough and they're on the ground, they probably have some way of punishing this. So this is a preemptive attempt to stop their jumps, not much else. And again, the light punch version is for ground pressure if they're blocking way too much, okay? Notice here, okay, the computer is set to one hit guard. Notice how slowly that came out even when I canceled the crouching C. There's no real way that, you're gonna get this to combo. It doesn't combo outside of a few fringe juggles, okay? So all it's for is if they block a lot, you get a lot of frame advantage and a handful of guard gauge as well. So that's all that the light one is for. Use the fierce one. It's up to your style how much you wanna use the fierce one, but you do wanna use it. Use it once in a while. The EX one is a combination of the light and the hard one. It has a bigger hitbox than both, and it moves forward, and it anti-airs, and it causes ground pressure. The only real difference between them is that the EX version does start up a little faster, okay? You can almost react to jumps from certain ranges. In fact, if we set Leona to full jump here, oop, a little too slow. Yeah. It's gonna depend on the character. I would still say it's not a great reaction anti-air, but if you were further away, like right here, this would absolutely work. Okay. So if you're about 80% of the screen away, it's a good reaction anti-air. It's faster on startup than the hard one, so you can actually use it on reaction at certain ranges, mostly full screen ranges, okay? But it does do a lot of hits, okay? Because it does do a lot of hits, Whatever you do afterwards is going to scale quite a bit. If you're unfamiliar, the combo scaling system maxes out at 16 hits, okay? But it does do a lot of damage by itself. If you're curious about combo scaling, there is information about that on the Dream Cancel forum, so feel free to check that out. But the Baltic Launcher, just to review, ground pressure if they block too much, preemptive anti-air, both, and a little faster on startup. Also, none of them are invincible on startup, just to get that out of the way. The next special move is her Moon Slasher, and this is a heavily misunderstood move, okay? Number one, there are some differences between the light and hard version as far as how they juggle. It's not really something that a beginner needs to know because it doesn't become super relevant until HD mode. All of your one bar, one drive combos, even if you do a Moon Slasher cancel, is going to be the hard punch to the hard kick version, okay? The light punch version of this has use in certain HD combos because they do cause different, they launch at different heights, okay? So in extended juggle combos, that is a difference. Damage-wise, they are the same when you're point-blank, okay? However, at the tipper range, it does vary. This one is 60, and the hard punch version, let's see, I believe I can actually get it to do a little less. Okay, never mind, but they do 80 when you're close, but they do 60 when you're further away, okay? Also, another interesting note is that the light punch version, you don't move at all. Look at Leona. I'm doing these light punch moon slashers. Now I'm going to start doing hard ones. You'll also notice it recovers a little slower. Light one. Fierce one. So the fierce one recovers a little slower, and it also inches her forward, okay? But damage-wise, they're going to be the same at the same ranges, okay? Now, what this move is for. This, if you're familiar with Street Fighter, is basically a flash kick, okay? This is a good reaction anti-air. Okay? It will beat almost everything in the game, Mutalus, if you're spaced correctly. Okay? You don't have to do it terribly early either. Okay. Because this is a charge move, and all you have to hit is up and punch, it is a bit easier for you to react to jumps with this move than other characters. Other characters would have to work a lot harder to anti-air with a special move. Her, you just hold down back, and as soon as you see it, you can go to up back, or straight up, or up forward, either one. Okay. And you can go ahead and anti-air with the light or the hard version. It doesn't really matter. What I will say is that the hard punch version, because of that little inch forward, is going to be a little bit more consistent, okay? Also notice on counter hit, I got 100 damage. The counter hit does a little bit of extra. Okay. EX, oh. And here's the EX version now. The EX version reaches further and is fully invincible. Okay, it also does more damage. Notice by itself, this does 160 damage by itself. Now I want to double check the frame data just to be clear on this. I think it might be a little faster on startup, but I will verify that before I open my big fat mouth. Leona! Moon Slasher! Now, that was my alarm. The Moon Slasher starts up in 7 frames. The EX Moon Slasher starts up in 4. Okay? So it is a little bit faster. Okay? That is something you'll want to keep in mind. Let's see. Now, also, this is something that a lot of people don't understand. The regular Moon Slashers are not invincible. You cannot wake up with them. Light Moon Slasher, beaten. Fierce Moon Slasher, beaten. EX Moon Slasher, fully invincible, okay? The regular Moon Slasher isn't invincible. If you're coming across Leona players that wake up with this, you just fail to meaty them. There was really nothing that you could have done that would not have beaten that move. It has no invincibility on it whatsoever. just so you know. Okay. Earring Bomb! This is a fun one. There's a light and a hard kick version and an EX. And let's see, let's start with this here. The light kick version, well, let's put it this way. All of the earring bombs have the same purpose. The purpose of the earring bomb is you recover so quickly that you can occupy multiple parts of the screen if you wish. If you were to jump and hit light kick, they would have to deal with the ground earring and deal with their jumping normal at the same time. If they were to jump at you, they would probably get hit by this. Another thing you can do with the earring is follow it in on the ground. Leona has a very low forward dash, and there's a lot of characters that if they do jumping normals, because of her low stance during her dash, they might actually miss. She can go under a lot of things. Plus, she'll actually get there just as the earring goes off. And if you get there as the earring goes off, if it hits, you can see that and go into a combo. But if it doesn't hit, let's say they block it, then you can use that block stun to get pressure started, okay? So they don't want to get hit by it, and they don't want to block it. So what you want to do is you want to try occupying different parts of the screen at the same time so that you can try to force them to move, okay? The light kick version bounces once. Okay, let me go ahead and record the dummy to do this here. Just so you can see how far it goes. Bounce. And then it dies, okay? It bounces once, and then when it hits the ground again, it dies, okay? But it is active for that second bounce. Okay? The hard kick version has the same idea. It bounces once, and then on the second bounce, it dies. However, it travels much further. You'll notice it goes full screen before it actually bounces. Same idea, it gets destroyed as soon as it hits the ground the second time, but it bounces once and it stays on the ground. So if they are backing up, you could try to use the hard kick version to cover more space. And the EX version, it starts up way faster, but it bounces twice, but it travels slower, okay? In fact, I would say this goes about the same total distance as the light kick version. Okay, but it does get an extra bounce that really doesn't add any distance. It goes about the same distance as the light kick. However, because of the quicker startup, it has some use in certain HD combos, number one. And number two, it does do more damage. Okay, the EX earring does 120, whereas the regular ones only do 65. Okay. Let's see here. But what this boot, but as I said, you want to use the light and the hard kick versions to try to occupy different parts of the screen to get your offense going. Because the startup is so slow, that more or less negates your ability to, say, cancel into it on block and try something. Like if you were to try, say, close hard kick, cancel it into earring, they recover so early before you that anybody with half a brain is probably going to try to punish you. Okay, this is not going to work up close. What you need to do is you need to establish a two-thirds screen or more distance, let it out, and if they do let that earring come out, then follow it in and get your offense going. Let's see, Grand Saber. Okay, another charge move here. Hold back, and then forward and a kick. It went off again, alarm. Jeez, okay. Now, this move, each one is a little different. First of all, the light kick version. Let's just go into this. The light kick version doesn't go very far. It goes about half screen. No matter what version you do, Leona goes into an automatic run. Okay? But if she gets to the opponent within a certain range, she lets out this slash. Now, the light kick version is very bad on block. Okay? They recover quite a bit before you, and better players will be able to punish you for this. Don't use the light kick version as a poke. The light kick version can be used in certain HD juggles, okay, because it's quicker than the D and the EX version to come out, but it can also be comboed into. Okay? Because it can be comboed into, you could try to do a simple combo like, say, this. Wait. In fact, it doesn't combo from close D, does it? No, it doesn't. Yeah. You could try to do, say, something like that as a simple combo. Okay? Now, the hard kick version... The hard kick version is actually frame even on block, okay? If you use the hard kick version, not only does it go a little further, it goes almost full screen. Or does it go full screen? You know what? It goes full screen. Yeah, this goes full screen. What am I saying? Yeah, so this goes full screen. And if they block this, you are frame neutral, okay? At this spot where you are frame neutral, you actually can use close normals. Okay, you could go for close C or close D if you wanted. You could try to hit up and hard kick at the same time. Hint, hint, I'll get to it later. Okay, you could also go for a quick crouching B if you think that they're going to jump or something. Okay, your mileage may vary, but the idea is it's frame even on block. So you and your opponent have the same decisions. You don't have any advantage, so if you actually come out on top in these frame-even situations, it'll have more to do with your mind games and what you choose to do, rather than the fact that they actually blocked it. This is sort of similar to Abel's step kick in Street Fighter IV. You get a guess afterwards, but that's all that you get. Okay, now on hit, the hard kick version recovers pretty fast. So if they're near the corner, you can actually continue the combo. And you can actually go into more hits. The light kick version, though, even if you land it in the corner, you recover too slowly to really do anything afterwards. Okay? Now the EX version of this... The EX version of this hits twice. Okay, not only does it hit twice, but on block, this is actually rather good. Let me get another bar here. Okay, on block, this is actually plus three. And you can use this to set up super legit mix-ups. Okay, because of the three frames of advantage you have, there's a lot that you can do there. And so you can decide for a better mix-up, a way better one than, say, just the D Grand Blade. The EX version gives plus 3 frame advantage, and it hits twice. It's also, I'm going to show you how it's useful in her HD mid-screen carry. Okay? Let's see. Okay. That just about covers that. Now, next is her Excalibur, which is quarterback punch in the air. Okay, this move serves pretty distinct purposes. The light one is your simple combo ender. Okay, you can just cancel into it off of that bread and butter combo. Okay, now when you hit with this, you get knocked away. Okay, you create a full screen distance again. Okay, you might not like that, but keep in mind with Leona, there's things she can do at full screen distance. Okay, you throw that earring, there's not much they can do about it unless they, say, have a super that reaches all the way over there, or a Neomax that reaches all the way over there. You can throw that earring and almost guarantee that it's going to work. This is also, ironically, the range where if they were to super jump at you, this is most effective. Okay, just things to keep in mind after you get that knockdown. However, on block, this is very terrible. Here. Let me, in fact, let me record the dummy to do this. Oh, where's my run at? Okay. That little bounce back isn't quite as easy to punish as, say, a Blanca Ball in Street Fighter 4, but you want to think of a similar idea when it comes to the punish. Do something quick that has horizontal range, and almost every character in the game will be able to easily punish this. In Leona's case, she can EX Moonslasher it, she can Super it. I mean, the options don't really end there. Okay, so when it comes to that quarterback punch move, make sure you don't do it if you haven't confirmed the combo, because you will be punished for it, okay? The hard punch version is much the same, but for a slightly different reason. Okay, if you do the hard punch version on block of the strike arcs there, it is going to whiff, and on whiff you are punishable. Okay, and on block you are punishable as well. But what makes it useful is that it hits in the corner. Even if this hits, it misses mid-screen, but it doesn't miss in the corner. Because it doesn't miss in the corner, this enables new combos. The corner is a great, great spot for Leona to have. After this, you can add a Moonslasher, okay? That's just the first thing you can do. If you add a drive cancel, you can go into even bigger damage, okay? If you get a bread and butter combo in the corner, then you want to combo into the hard version of the Excalibur. But just like the light one, it's terrible on block. It's also terrible on whiff, which is what'll happen if you're too far or if you're mid-screen. Now the EX version of the Excalibur serves a different purpose. Outside of some fringe, you know, trial combo sorts of juggles, this hits 6 times. Okay, so let's go ahead and set them to guard this. Okay, when they guard this, let's do it the dummy way. I was actually holding up there. Look at all that block stun. I'm holding up. Look how long I'm stuck in block stun. It lasts forever. I am holding up as soon as I block it. Look how long that block stun lasts. You can use that almost like a further range light Baltic launcher to put them into block stun. If it hits, all 6 of those hits will connect and you can get a combo if you want. And if it does get blocked, then you could force a mix-up on that block, okay? So it's very, very useful on block. Also, don't forget, you can do air special moves out of a backdash. So, if you knock a Leona player down, one thing you could do, let's set him to one guard, one hit guard here so he blocks it. I'm gonna knock her down. Then you do it out of a backdash, okay? And to do that, you insert quarterback and then back again. And then hit the punches after the second back. You will do it instantly out of your backdash. And so you can cause this free pressure to happen on knockdown situations that they have to roll out of or try to guard cancel. It's very similar to Terry's EX Fireball. Let's see, what else? There was something that I might have forgotten about the EX Earring Bomb. I just want to double check that before I move on here. Yeah, it actually does destroy projectiles. Okay. It won't destroy super strength fireballs. feel free to test it against different fireballs to get mileage out of it. But regular fireballs, if you see one, you can throw the EX earring to go through it and guarantee that pressure, assuming, of course, that they're in range of that second bounce. Okay? That was just something I wanted to say before I continued. Now, next, I want to get into her supers and Neomax, and then I'll move on to some combos and some other practical stuff with her. I probably said that wrong. Isn't it Anata de wa? Ah, forget it. I don't know Japanese. Just sounds cool. Alright. Next. Supers. I should turn the damage on for this. V slasher is why you should play Leona. Okay? It really, really is. Her V slasher has multiple angles and multiple uses, but it is probably one of the most invincible air moves in the game, and because the hard and EX versions have such tremendous range, this move has an incredible amount of space control, especially on reaction. You do not have to read opponents to land this. If you jump and you input the super motion, you can just wait and see if they jump, and if they jump, you just hit that punch and you get that damage. Okay? It does 220 damage on the light and the hard versions. The EX version causes 340. You also recover a lot faster from the EX version, and it enables some mid-screen juggles to be possible, okay? Now, the V-slasher can be comboed into, very simply, from the forward light kick because you are airborne. Either version will work. Okay. But again, its primary use, and this is the thing you really need to get used to. Ah, I missed it. But if you're really far away, like really far away, and you buffer this as you jump. If you buffer this as you jump, you will get there, okay? This reaches almost full screen. Almost. Not quite. But as long as you're anywhere in their general vicinity, if you see that jump, and you're ready for it, and you buffer. Oh, I'm missing it. Let's just show an example where I don't miss it. Okay. Let's say we're having a match here. Let's say I just hit her with this earring, and then I decide to wait over here. And then I jump at this time. I can easily see that jump and try to react to it. Okay, so you need to already be in the air. But if you do see it coming, you can absolutely try to react with the super. I might be giving a terrible example, just trust me on this. In fact, it's way easier if they full jump. But this is one of the major reasons to play Leona. If you can get them to jump at you, and it doesn't matter which jump you do, if you jump away, okay? Jumping away is perfectly viable with Leona. You buffer that super as you jump away, and then you have a million years to see that they jumped, and then you can react to that jump, okay? Now, the light and the hard version have a different angle on them, and that will be important. The light punch version comes down at a very, very steep angle. It's almost like 10 degrees. Okay? It comes almost straight down. The hard punch version has an angle of about 60, 70 degrees, I would say, and it reaches almost full screen from a full jump. Look at that. Step forward. Look at that. Not hard at all. It practically does reach full screen. Not full scientific definition of screen, but in a practical sense, a full screen, it absolutely does cover the entire screen. And because of this angle, there's really no type of jump they can use to get away from it. The hitbox on it is huge, and Leona is fully invincible while she's in the air. What else do you want out of an air super? It is quite excellent, and this is the main reason you want to play Leona. Now, this makes her sort of meter use. This makes her sort of meter dependent. But this is why, even though she's a decent point, put her second or third on your team. That's just my opinion, though. Okay. And the EX version actually has an angle that is in between the light and the hard versions. I think this one has a 45 degree angle. I haven't drawn it out, but it has about a 45 degree angle. Okay, it does more damage, and you also recover relatively quickly. If you catch someone in the air with this, because how quickly you recover, it is usually possible for you to continue this combo. Okay, if you catch them high enough in the air, you can usually do something else there. Okay. And remember, EX Moon Slasher starts faster than the other one, so if you're not sure, try the EX one. But it causes a full juggle state that you can usually combo off of, if they're high enough in the air. Just keep that in mind. Okay. Her Slash Saber. Her Slash Saber is pretty good. Not the greatest super, though. First and foremost, it's not invincible on startup. Okay. I also want to stress, even though V-Slasher is air invincible, because it is an air super, by definition, it cannot be used as a ground wake-up move, because you would have to jump first. Okay. You can do it, actually, let me do this before I move on to the Slasher. You can use the V-Slasher, you can use it instantly by simply doing the motion and then adding up back. Okay? Do the super motion, but then hit up back and hit the punch as soon as you leave the ground. And you'll do it instantly as you leave the ground. Remember that the angles come into play here, so if you do the light punch version, it's not really going to go anywhere. EX version also not really going to go anywhere. You can use the hard punch version as a punish to certain things. For example, Duolon. Reka 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 teleport, you can actually instant hard punch version V-Slasher punish that teleport. That is if it's the light teleport, anyway. Now, the Slash Saber, if we look at the damage here, the last hit of Slash Saber always does 60 unscaled, okay? The other hits do scale, but the last hit of this always does 60. This is actually a decent ender to HD combos and other combos in general if they're particularly long, but it is kind of long on startup, okay? Okay, it's too slow to work in that particular corner situation, okay? But it is relatively fast as far as how far it travels. If somebody does something that's punishable from really far away, you can use this to get over to them relatively fast and still get that combo. And notice that after the super hits, the opponent lands right next to you. Let me go ahead and turn on the passive move here. Okay, they are able to quick recover, but you do recover relatively fast as well, and you can absolutely stay on them. Okay, so just keep that in mind. It's mostly used as a punish in certain situations. It's also good at the end of certain combos. I wouldn't throw it out there. It's not invincible, but it is good at punishing things on whiff. For example, Maxima's quarterback punch, any slow, laggy normal, any special that's unsafe on block. Usually this will punish, and it will get there relatively fast. And again, the last hit does 60. Okay, her Neomax. It has a lot more range than most Neomaxes overall. It actually reaches full screen, but there is a certain range where you, of course, do not get the final real damage-dealing hit, okay? When you're within about a half screen range... Ooh, even a little closer. Okay, so you need to be at about the range of where the round starts. Okay? This range here of how about where the round starts, that is about the maximum effective range of Neomax. But it does two hits for 450. Okay. and it it does it all in one hit though, and it is not really fast enough to punish certain things. It's good for punishing like missed uppercuts and things like that, but most Neomaxes are. It is a great HD combo ender. It's very easy to combo into an HD. I mean, if you consider Leona's combos easy, I will get to that. But honestly, outside of HD, you don't really see it much. I believe it is invincible. Let me re-record this. There we go. Once we get B, so Neomax now. Yeah. The Neomax is invincible on startup, but other than like a surprise wake up ultra or whatever, it's really not a great tool overall, I'd say. But it is a great HD combo ender. Now, that just about covers the utility of her moves. Now we get to the fun part. Now I get to show you the combos. As usual, I will keep this section as short and sweet as possible. I don't go into anything super advanced, okay? Some simple combos you can use. These are really the only ones that I use. That's a good Mutalisk combo. If you want, you can throw a bar onto it. Okay, relatively simple. You can use low jab for these confirms if you wish. You can even mix it up like this. Or even like this. Okay, you have lots of normal variation that you can use, so make sure you're using them. If you do land one of these combos in the corner, exact same combos, you can cancel into the hard punch version of the Excalibur. Stun! I'll go ahead and turn that off here. Then you can combo into the hard punch version of the Excalibur, and you can follow up with a Moon Slasher. Okay, and you can also drive cancel that into her Grand Blade for even more damage. Now I want to go over this just so you understand how this is possible. This is a drive cancel that gives a lot of people some trouble. I just want to go over this relatively quickly. You can do her Moon Slasher by going from down back to up back. Okay, and then while you're in up back, you can move from up back to up forward to do the Grand Blade. In KOF13, you can do charge moves using the up forward corner for back forward moves. You couldn't do that in Street Fighter, okay? So what you can do is you can go from down back to up forward. Because you're going from down back to up back, you keep your back charge. And then it's simply a matter of instantly doing the air super, okay? And how do you do it instantly? Remember, do the super motion, then hit up back, and then hit the punch as soon as you leave the ground. Okay, using that information, you should be able to get those combos in the corner. Again, anytime you could combo a B-Slasher, don't forget, you could go for level 2. For just a bit more damage. Okay, now, Crouching B is not your only combo tool. Close Hard Kick hits twice, just like with King, so you can use it to easily confirm many of the same combos. All good to know. If you want to be perfect, you could try to, if you want it to be perfect, you could try to link Crouching C. Okay, you could try to link Crouching C from Crouching B, then go into the forward B and then into the combos. Okay, now, this will be something that, a lot of you will probably want to know. Instant overhead, okay? When you are getting pressure with Leona, there will invariably be times where you are in your opponent's face. With Leona, you can use two different air normals in her air super to create 50-50 situations if they choose to block. They could backdash these, they could roll these, they could reversal these. Keep that in mind. This is not a super unbeatable tactic or anything like that. But if you have someone that blocks too much, Leona can 50-50 that character easily. And it doesn't matter what character they are. if you are point blank. Okay. This her jumping hard kick. Remember her jumping hard kick? If you full jump. Yeah. If you full jump straight up. Okay. It has to be a full jump. It has to be a full jump, and it has to be a neutral full jump. This only happens on neutral full jumps. If you hop and hit D on the way down, nothing happens. Okay? This has to be a neutral full jump. Okay? On a neutral full jump, her hard kick changes, and it becomes this weird-looking thing. Okay? It hits directly in front of her. What you can use this for is you can hit it on the way up. So how you want to do this normal is you want to hold up and hit hard kick as soon as you leave the ground. If you miss, you're hitting the hard kick too late. Okay? But, I'm going to set them to one guard, one hit guard here. You can actually combo into the light Excalibur if you are close enough. Which means that if they are guarding low in front of your face, you can still get a combo. Okay? That is very useful. Okay, that's number one. Okay. You can still use this poke when you're one poke away. Even if you're one poke away, this still works. In fact, let me, do it this way. Okay. If you are one low B or one low A away, you can still use this, okay? But keep in mind, it might not combo. Okay? Notice from one crouching B away, this doesn't combo, but from one crouching A away, it does, okay? That's a distinct difference that you might just want to take note of. Now, you might ask, what if I'm two away? Well, you still have an instant overhead. It's actually hyper hop, light punch. It needs to be a hyper hop. I cannot stress this enough. That's incorrect. It can be a normal hop, okay? But you are probably going to hyper hop if you try to go into the super, which is probably the main reason you're going for the instant overhead in the first place. You can get a super off of this, and let me show you the motion for it for both. Let's say you do some crouching light kicks. You want to input a quarter forward, up forward. If you do this quickly enough, this gives you a hyper hop. And you need to hit the light punch the instant you leave the ground. Again, if you miss or if you super jump, then you hit the light punch too late. You can practice this just by setting the dummy to crouching guard. Not crouch auto guard, not crouch one hit guard or anything like that. Just set them to crouch guard. And you can practice landing this. Okay. This works from two pokes away. This includes different poke variations. There we go. Come on. I know that works. Yeah, two low jabs. Low jab, low short. Short, short. Short standing jab. This will work. Ugh, my hands are actually falling asleep, though. I'm a little tired today. But anytime you land any of these instant overheads, you can absolutely go into a super, okay? So once you've practiced that quarter forward, up forward, and you hyper hop, and you hit that light punch, you immediately hit a half circle back and then a punch so that it's a clean motion. You technically don't need the half. You could just do a quarter back. But considering you just hit up forward, it's going to be a lot easier on your hands if you come all the way around. Okay. Another thing you could do is you could go from down to up forward and hit light punch, then hit up. I don't know, this is kind of unwieldy, and then come straight down for the quarterback. Do whatever is comfortable for you, but you need to have a quarter forward before you hit that light punch, so that when you hit quarterback, you get the super. Okay. And a similar concept is employed for the neutral jump hard kick. This is the cleanest motion that you can do. Let me record the dummy here so I can get this clean for you. Okay. What you want to do is you want to input a quarter forward and then neutral jump. Remember, it needs to be a neutral jump. So quarter forward and then jump straight up, hold that up, hit the hard kick as quick as possible, then quickly hit a quarterback punch. Since you went straight up here, I would recommend you just come straight down and then do a quarterback. You could come around if that's easier for you, but speed is the key factor here. I've been practicing this motion a long time, and that's why I'm able to get it a lot. But the idea is, this is how you do it from one poke away with the hard kick, and you can do it from two pokes away with the jab. You can also do it point blank with the jab. They don't need to be, it doesn't need to be hard kick. If you're point blank, you can absolutely use the jab if that is easier for you. It also doesn't matter which strength of super you use. Okay. So that, using your instant overhead smartly, you can really make people fear guarding low. Okay. Learning how to incorporate it into your ground-based offense is what'll make you a super, super scary Leona. Now I need to talk about hyperdrive. And this is one of the main reasons people don't like Leona. It is difficult, okay? Absolutely it is, I understand that. But the reason you would want to learn Leona HD combos, as I said earlier, is because her damage is comparable to Shen at almost every screen position and for every position and for every amount of meter. 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bars, 4 bars, she comes within 60 damage or so of his values, no matter where he is on the screen. So her HD damage is very high compared to most characters in the game. The execution is tougher, but strategically speaking, it is so strong that you can get lots of kills with her HD if you know how to use it. This is part of the reason Leona's a pretty good anchor. I would recommend putting her second just because you can play her a less risky style, but again, it is up to you how you decide to play her. Now I want to start with the HD that you can use when they're near the corner. This is one that I picked up from a combo video, and I'll show you two different confirms you can use for it. Okay, you absolutely can HD from close hard kick. What you want to do is you want to activate the HD late. When you activate the HD late, that's why those normals come out automatically. Leona's one of those characters that can really use that, okay? She doesn't want the auto dash as often. In fact, I don't even use the auto dash with Leona. What you can do is you want to activate late you want to hold down back when you do the close D, and then you want to activate late. This gives you down charge, and it also gives you a crouching hard punch, okay? Okay, then when it hits, you want to go to a fierce moon slasher, and you're going to do a simple loop many times. Watch this. Okay, remember when I was talking about this drive cancel, where you go from down back to up forward. All you're doing is looping that. What's important is that you go to down back immediately after you finish the other special, like so. Notice how quickly I'm returning to down back on this series here. The instant I hit that hard kick, the moment I know that special move is coming out, I immediately come back to hard kick. Charge time in KOF is only 30 frames. If you are quick, and you hit the corners quickly, you will be able to charge enough so that you can get the next special. Okay? That's what you need to do. Now, this works from on the left and the right side, of course, but this is a good HD when they're within about a third of the screen to the corner. If you have 2 bars, turn it into a Neomax. Yeah. It's just under 900 damage for two bars. That is very, that is absolutely nothing that you want to scoff at. Adding a jump in would get it close to 900, okay? Now, as far as that last cancel, I want to go over that. Remember that her Neomax motion is quarter back and then half forward. It takes a little bit of creative thinking to think of how you can fit a charge move into this, but what your motion will end up being is you're going to input the Moon Slasher as down to up back. Okay, you want to go all the way to up back, and then when that actually connects, you want to come all the way back around and do a quarter forward. Okay, by doing the half forward, this gives you the quarter forward that you need. If you do this motion quickly enough, notice you just quarter backed to Moon Slasher, and then after the Moon Slasher, you did quarter forward. Let me show you that motion one more time. Okay. This is one of the main reasons I recommend a square gate if you're using an arcade stick. A square gate is useful when you're playing Leona because you need those corners, and you will find yourself returning to them in the middle of your HD combos. Oh, I dropped it! Notice, I dropped this and I'm really glad I did so you can see this. Look at my input display. I'm gonna give you a couple seconds, just so you can try to figure out exactly where the problem was. As you can see, I did the half circle, and then I hit the two punches. So what happened? What happened was, before that, even though I got the Moon Slasher to come out with my down charge, I missed down back in the quarter back. I missed the bottom left corner. Because I missed the bottom left corner, I didn't get the quarter back. The game didn't see a quarter back, which means it wouldn't give me that Neomax, okay? This is something you can really practice. Okay? Whoop! Too late. It will take more practice to be good with Leona's HDs, I would say, than almost any other character in the game. They are complicated, but they are damaging. And if you want to be a good Leona player, you need to learn them. Now, that is her corner HD combo. In fact, let me give you some variants here. Let me give you 3 and 4 bar variants. Add an EX Moon Slasher for the first one to do a bit more damage. And if you have 4 bars, again, start with EX. But then cancel that last series into the Leona Blade. Into the Slash Saber, and then max cancel that to the Neomax. That comes very close to a kill without a jump in. Notice that was without a jump in. If I added a jump in, this would practically kill for 4 bars. She has a fun 5-bar trial combo that kills in the corner. I won't spoil it, but if you can do her later trials, you do have a 5-bar kill combo. Okay? Now, what if you need to carry them across the screen? There are many variants to this, just like with Claw Iori. There are many different ways that you can use Leona specials to carry. However, there is one combo that always carries, no matter how far it is, and all you need is one EX Grand Blade. This is going to be the one that I'm going to use in most of my matches just to simplify it for myself, and this is an HD you can use at any point on the screen and it will always connect. All you need is one bar for the carry. Let me show you that one more time. Again, late activation into Crouching C into Moon Slasher. Starts off the exact same. However, when you get that Moon Slasher, you're going to cancel to the EX Grand Blade. Oh, got the throw. That's not the combo. But you will fail that times many times. When the second hit of the EX Grand Blade comes out, you're gonna cancel to hard Moon Slasher and cancel that to hard Grand Blade. Simple series, you've done this before. Actually, that'll be a good time to explain that. Sometimes you get a crouching light kick when you do the bypass. I'm having trouble figuring out exactly why that happens. I'm still trying to figure that out. But you'll be happy to know, even if that does happen, this combo still works, and you still get it. So don't worry if that accidentally comes out, but the crouch C does get more damage, so you do want to endeavor to do that version. Also, if you're full screen, you do need the crouch C, because it does move Leona forward a little bit, otherwise the combo will drop. As long as your back isn't in the corner, though, both versions will work anywhere on the screen. Get out of the corner. Okay, after you do the series of hard punch moonslasher to hard kick grand blade, you're going to do a light grand blade by itself. No drive cancel. Let me show you again. Okay, just a light grand blade by itself. You recover quickly, and then you get to do two more simple loops. Hard punch moonslasher to hard kick, hard punch moonslasher to hard kick. Do that twice. Oh, that's gonna drop. That's gonna drop. Let's try again. Okay. Also keep in mind, when you do the hard punch to hard kick, you let the hard kick grand blade finish, and then you do another moonslasher to grand blade. You don't need to cancel that grand blade to the moonslasher. It's possible for some of the more complicated combos to do that. However, this combo is simplified at the cost of a bar so that it always works. Okay, after you do the second group of moonslasher to hard grand blade, this should work. Yep. You do another light grand blade by itself. Okay, and then you'll have just a little bit of drive meter left over. And at that point, you can do another series. Another series of Moonslasher to Grand Blade, and then a final Moonslasher to finish it off. Now, if you have meter, there's things you can do with this. Okay, let's say you had two bars here. Oh, dropped it, but you know how it's gonna finish now. And again, remember, that does 60 damage unscaled at the end. Okay, so that will do good damage. This is 770 damage for a 2-bar HD that works anywhere on the screen. Nothing to shake a stick at. Nothing to scoff a sneeze at. I need better colloquialisms. It's not working. But now, that ends with another Moonslasher drive cancel. This is actually the exact same as the Neomax one, it's just the other direction. You're gonna go from down to up back, and then finish with that quarter forward. No wait, actually it's the same direction. Excuse me. Notice that the motion for her slash saber and her Leona blade are exactly the same. So the drive cancel will be exactly the same. The only difference is for this, you hit a kick instead of two punches. And if you have more meter, you can absolutely do more damage. Oh, dropped it again. Didn't EX that time. Sayonara. 900 damage, 3 bars anywhere on the screen. What if we go to 4? After the second series, of Moonslasher Grandblade, Moonslasher Grandblade in the corner, do a Slash Saber by itself, no drive cancel. And then max cancel it. And for 4 bars anywhere on the screen, you've got 989 damage, which is, in effect, a kill, unless they had full life. And that was off of the jump-in. Even if you don't have the jump-in, this is still ridiculous damage. Being able to use Leona's HD combos and being able to use her instant overheads are what are going to make you a good Leona player, and those are the things that are going to make Leona playable in KOF 13 tournaments. This is how I'm going to play her, and this is what I want to show to the KOF community when I do go to tournaments, when I go to EVO, and to the tournaments beyond that. I don't think Leona's a bad character at all, but it requires a good command of reaction, air, super, good practice on her HD combos, good execution in general, and good fundamentals, because her close range offense is rather basic. Okay? But if you can take advantage of those things, you can be a good Leona player. Okay? Last thing I'll leave you with is how to confirm into this from crouching light kicks. If you do 3 crouching light kicks quick, then when you HD late, you will still get the crouching C and you get all the same combos. And for 4 bars full screen off of 3 crouching light kicks, you still get 930 damage. Okay? All the HDs that I showed you how to start with close hard kick, you could also start with close hard punch if you like, and with 3 crouching light kicks as well. Okay? So that just about covers it. There's not much else to show. Here's a fun little gimmick, I guess. That's fun to do. You can activate HD and that super at the same time, and then you can max cancel her level 2 B-slasher. If you're curious, you cannot max cancel her level 1 B-slasher, only her level 2. But other than that, I don't have much else to show you. That's Leona in a nutshell, and I really hope you pick her up. I think she's a great character, and I think that if you can use her, and actually use her well, especially in HD, that your execution will improve tremendously.